This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Prime. Welcome to the Property Show. We bring you the latest developments in the real estate sector and also the best property picks in your budget in your chosen markets. And to help us do this, we have Nemunisa Khan, Head Research and Consultancy South of Lysis Forest with us. Welcome to the show, Nemun. But before Nemun answers any of your questions, let's take a look at what we have for you in the show today. 2 years after its launch by the Urban Development Ministry, transit-oriented development policy remains a non-starter. We do a fact check on the show today. Also on the show, we will be scouting for affordable homes in the Noida property market. Top projects along the golf course extension road in Gurgaon in a crore plus budget. Prime properties in the emerging residential destinations of Lucknow. Our next stop, Western India, for pocket-friendly options in Vadodara. And down south, affordable projects in Chennai that are worth your money. And on the World Environment Day, step inside Delhi's greenest offices to learn how they are setting an example for others. In 2015, the Delhi Development Authority or DDA announced its plans to construct two transit-oriented development projects, one in Karkaduma and the other one near the Sanjay Lake in Trilokpuri, both in East Delhi. These were to address the growing problems of pollution, congestion and shortage of housing stock for the poor and middle class. 2 years later, we decided to do a status check on the progress of these much talked about TOD projects, and here is what we found. No sign of any work done.
This is Sanjay Lake in East Delhi's Trilokpuri area, located just next to the Trilokpuri metro station. This is the location where one of DDA's mixed-use transit-oriented development project is to come up. As per DDA's plans announced 2 years ago, this lake, surrounded by garbage and dirt, was to be rejuvenated and maintained, giving it a new lease of life. Furthermore, a lake view complex with an iconic twin tower having 50 to 60 stories plus a commercial hub was to come up here. The project was to be developed by NBCC, but there is no sign of any work happening yet.
Projects which we have got from DDA, design is ready like today you have seen, but TOD policy has not been notified. Once that is notified, those projects will always start.
You mean to say everything is on track?
Yeah.
As far as the TOD?
Yes.
The story is no different at the site of the other TOD project that was to come up in Karkaduma in 75 acres. 4,800 housing units and 80,000 square meter of retail space was to be built here. But here too, work is yet to begin. And here is what experts have to say regarding the delay.
It needed a lot more research. We don't right now know how property valuation is actually operating, not well enough. Circle rates and market values are now not in sync with each other. So, you know, how do you really intervene in a market like that? And TOD is a lot about market forces, right? Transit-oriented development is about investments in public transport and then investments from the private sector that support that and support the huge density it creates.
A transit-oriented development is a mixed-use residential and commercial development catering to the housing needs of mixed-income groups with increased connectivity to a mass rapid transport mode and offer pedestrian and cycle friendly environments.
To make it happen, what is required is that it is not only the landowning agency or the developers who will come with some kind of proposal of redevelopment. It is also to see that the network, the road network and the connectivities which are established and which are pedestrian and NMT friendly.
Under the master plan of Delhi 2021, at least 4 TOD projects are proposed. These include corridors on the Chhatarpur to Arjungar metro stations, Piragari to Tikrikalan metro stations, Dwarka Mor to Dwarka Sector 21 metro stations, and Nehru Place to Badarpur stations. The beautification and maintenance of this lake and the work, the construction work on the transit-oriented development is now expected to gain momentum given the fact that the Urban Development Ministry has announced the National Transit-Oriented Development Policy. From Trilokpuri in East Delhi, with camera person Sajilal, Oinitam Oja for NDTV.
Now let's go ahead and take our callers on air. We have our first caller, Shariq Hassan Siddiqui, with us. Mr. Siddiqui, please ask your question.
Well, I am looking for a 2 BHK apartment, about 65 to 75 lakhs.
Okay.
And the area is Noida.
Okay, sure. So, Nemun, 60 to 65 lakhs, and if I'm not wrong, he also wants something which is either ready to move in or should be ready in next 6 months. So, what do you suggest? First, which area would you choose for him, and also then the projects?
Well, if he's looking at nearing completion projects and also looking at Noida market, I think in his price point, Central Noida market would be more appropriate for him. The average price out here is around 4,999 rupees per square foot. So accordingly, I think a 2 BHK of a larger size or a compact 3 BHK may also be something that he'll be able to find in this price bracket in Central Noida. And if you look at Central Noida also, I would say that because of a lot of projects getting ready now in this year and by this year end, it's also graduating towards a mature market. So it is moving it is going through a transition, and it will be definitely a good investment for you if you look into this area. The appreciation out here currently has been around 1.5%, and if you invest here, the rent that you can achieve in this area would be around 12 to 17 rupees per square foot, depending on the kind of views and furniture that you place in your apartment. So that is a current rental thing. Now, coming to the projects, according to your choice, we have picked JM Aroma, which is in Sector 75. This is a resale project, and it is right on the road, which is intersecting Central Noida, that is the Link Road. And you can also look at Apex Athena in the same Sector 75 itself. But this is not in resale, this is in finishing stages. But if you are a golf player or you love playing golf, then you'll really like this project, because it's a part of a larger township of the Golf City Township. And thirdly, we have picked Elite's Home. This is in Sector 77. It is slightly away from the Link Road, but however, the price is quite reasonable, and this is also something that you may be able to get in the resale market.
Okay, so let's quickly take a look at the prices so that you can get an idea which project would you rather buy. First is JM Aroma, and the price that you'll have to pay here is ranging from 5,200 to 5,500 rupees per square foot. This is an all-inclusive price. And unit size for a 3 BHK apartment is 1,325 square feet. The other option that Nemun has suggested is Apex Athena. The price here is 5,050 rupees per square foot. And unit size for a 2 BHK apartment is 1,295 square feet. The third option is Elite Homes. And the price that you'll have to pay for this particular project is 5,000 rupees per square foot. Again, an all-inclusive price. And the unit size for a 2 BHK apartment is 1,317 square feet. So these are the three options that Nemun is suggesting. Let's go ahead and take the next question on air, which has been sent as an email to us. Sunny Singh writes that his budget is almost about 1.5 crores and he wants to buy either a 3 BHK or a 4 BHK flat. The size should be at least 2,000 square feet. He wants a big house and it's for his self-use in Gurgaon. Now, he wants something that should be delivered to him either right now or within 3 to 4 months. What do you suggest, Nemun? He has already shortlisted Bestic Park View Spa and Imar Emerald Estate also. So do you have something else also for him, or do you think these two are good enough for him?
Well, I think he's chosen the decent projects. It's on the Golf Course Extension Road, and the budget that he is talking about, I think this is a decent area to go in. It is seeing a lot of demand trickling from the golf course road itself. And if you look at the average price here, it's around 11,600 rupees per square foot. And particularly this project which he has selected, I think this project is partially ready. In fact, recently MRMGF has also received OC for Emerald Hills Floor, Emerald Flow Select and Spanish Villas. Basically, this project is it has plots, villas, low-rise residential development as well. Also, because of low-rise, there is a certain amount of premium that is there to this project, and that's why it's slightly expensive. So, I think comparatively, the second project that he chose, Bestek Park View, which is next to the Badshahpur village, I think this is also a premium project. It's a fine developer, but the 3 BHKs out here are not as largely sized, like a 2,000 square feet 3 BHK may not be available in this particular project, whereas you might get something of the similar size in Emerald. MR Emerald Estate. So I think you should look at Emerald Hills as your rank one project, like the first choice. And Park View Spa is also a very nice project. If you are interested in a smaller size to 3 BHK, then even this may be a good option. And I think from our side, we've also suggested one more project. It's in Sector 67 by the name of M3M Merlin. This is slightly on the internal road, but again, it is in the middle of some residential, and there are a lot of commercial activities also around it. So this might also prove to be a good option for you.
So definitely, as you can see, that the price is also a little less because it's on an internal road. You have to just pay 6,200 rupees per square foot here as compared to the other ones. So this is one option that Naimun is suggesting to you apart from your own two chosen places. Now let's go ahead and take our next caller on air. We have Mr. Ashok Kumar with us. Yes, Ashok, what do you want to know?
We are looking for apartments in Omex Residency.
Okay.
And the budget is 65 to 70 lakhs.
Okay, so this Omex residency is in Gomti Nagar Extension. That's where you're looking at. And you said, can you please repeat your budget? Sorry.
65 to 70 lakhs.
Okay, fine. So, Naimun, 65 to 70 is the budget, but he is particularly interested in Omex residency. So, let's first focus on the area. What do you think about Gomti Nagar Extension?
Well, I think in terms of location, he's chosen a decent location. It's literally the extension of Gomti Nagar, which is one of the important commercial hubs of South Lucknow. So I think it's well connected as well, and it is also getting developed as a sports hub. There is a stadium which is already built. There is an upcoming sports complex. Then there's an international level cricket stadium also. So I think considering the kind of futuristic scenario this area gives, at the price point which you're going to get, 3,500 rupees per square foot is the average price here, it's a very decent buy for South Lucknow. The appreciation out here is around 0.8%. I think from our end, apart from Omex Residency, which we will definitely give a go-ahead to because it's a wonderful project from an end-user point of view. It's a larger community, and I think right now the project is also in a ready-to-move-in stage, and the occupancy is also good. So we'll give you a go-ahead for Omex Residency. And apart from that, we will suggest two more projects which are in the same proximity with similar advantages, and infrastructure and amenities are also very similar. You can look at Riveria Residency, which is in Sector 6. This is bang on the Amar Shaheed Park itself in Gomti Nagar Extension. In fact, around 25 families are already living in this project. And then you can also look at Parth Adayant. This is in Sector 7 in the Gomti Nagar Extension itself. And this project is located on intersection of Amar Shaheed Path and Sultanpur Road. So connectivity-wise, even this is pretty decent. And in fact, I think this project has a mix of hospital blocks, service apartments. So it's a mixed land use. And it is also in the finishing stages of construction. So even this might be a good option.
Okay, so let's take a closer look at these two projects. First is Riviera Residency, and the price that you'll have to pay for a flat over here is 4,200 rupees per square foot. And in case you opt for a 3 BHK, the size you'll get is 1,450 square feet. The other option that Nemuna suggested is Parth Adyant, and the price here is 3,900 rupees per square foot, and unit size for a 3 BHK apartment actually is ranging, and you will get a unit size from 1490 up to 1911 square feet. So these are the options that you can put your money in. Now, before we move on, we would just like to remind you that in case you need any advice about buying or selling a property, then do write to us at property@ndtv.com. But please don't forget to leave your full name and contact number so that our team can get in touch with you. And as you would have noticed, we also have a new look. In case you want to give your feedback, do write to us also. Now, let's go ahead and take our next caller on air. We have Deepak Gehani with us right now. Deepak, go ahead and ask your question.
Hi, ma'am. I'm from Vadodara, Gujarat, and I have a budget of 35 to 45 lakhs. Okay. I'm looking for a property size of 3 BHK, which is under construction, and I'm looking for position time within 2 years. Can you suggest 3 lakhs?
For sure. So, what do you suggest in Vadodara, Nemun? Which is the area that would give him good appreciation also?
Well, in Vadodara, mostly you get a lot of end-user demand, and affordable segment is actually taking an upward swing in Vadodara. And the kind of segment that he's looking at, I think he should look at the Gotri area. It's you can say Gotri is slightly on the periphery of Vadodara, of Vadodara, but it is actually seeing a lot of demand because of the push factor of areas closer to it, like Alkapuri, Saurabh Park, Sayajipura. These areas are currently having a saturation of land bank, and because of which a lot of demand is trickling towards Gotri, and that's how Gotri is developing. So I think eventually it will engulf the urban sprawl, and it will be a part of the entire community itself. So if you're looking at investment, I think Gotri would be a decent area to consider. The average price out here is 2,656 rupees per square foot only. So a 3 BHK will be easily affordable within the ticket size that you're looking at. And if you look at the annualized returns, it's around 5.6%, which is pretty decent in the past 3 years. And like I said, in 45 lakhs, you can actually get a 3 BHK from a reputed builder within Gotri. So we've already picked up some projects for you. You can look at ISKCON Habitat. This is something that you may get in the resale market as well. It's a ready property. And I would suggest, I know your timeline is, you don't mind a project which is in, you know, may get completed in 2 years. But having said that, if the property is already ready, then the risks are minimum. So I think we will suggest you properties which are almost in the finishing stages. You can look at Akshar Pavilion and Jalsa. Both of these are located in Gotri itself, and they are in the finishing stages of their construction, and they are most likely to get completed by the end of 2017. So these might be good options in your ticket size as well.
Okay, so let's quickly take a look at the prices that you will have to pay in these three projects. First is ISKCON Habitat, and the price here is 3,000 rupees per square foot, and unit size for a 2 BHK apartment is 1,420 square feet. The second option that Nemun has given to you is Akshar Pavilion, and the price that you'll have to pay is 2,500 rupees per square foot. And in case you buy a 3 BHK, the size you get is 1,475 square feet. And the last option that she suggested is Jalsa, and the price here is 2,100 rupees per square foot, and unit size for a 3 BHK apartment is quite massive. You get 2,220 square feet in your 3 BHK apartment. So these are the three options in Vadodara for you. It's time for a short break now. When we come back, we get you prime property in top residential areas of Mumbai and best property deals in Pune that fit your budget.